Well, good morning, everyone. First, I would like to thank you for interesting in OPSEC. I want to invite you to visit the ISO 2016 that will be held in Mexico City. This is a link where you can follow us. And well, today, you're going to learn about how to make mathematical models without programming. I want to tell you about the information systems as an alternative to make complex mathematical models. I want to show you how to use Excel as an interface for any optimization technology. I want to show you also how to connect SQL databases without knowing SQL, and how to use OPSEC as an optimization server. Well, OPSEC is a meta framework, it's an expert system, it's a robot that is oriented to design, implement, and set up decision support system based on mathematical programming. With OPSEC, the algebraic formulation is independent from any computer programming language. With OPSEC, you can connect with any data server, and also you can connect to any visualization system. With OPSEC, we generate applications using commercial and non-commercial technologies according to the client needs. OPSEC was developed to solve real mathematical problems in 1991, and it dramatically simplifies the developing and solving of complex optimization applications by supporting rapid prototyping, big data intensive optimization, decision making under uncertainty, integrate multiple languages and optimization technologies, optimization in the cloud, and recently we added advanced optimization using Excel tables. OPSEC is the result of too many years of experience. It's an innovative tool that has been proven in practice. We have done too many mathematical models that have been developed to the end client, and these models now can be shared with companies or universities that we have technological alliances. Because right now, the analytics is sharing the benefits of OPSEC with the mathematical programming community. What do you think if I tell you that you can program in several technologies at the same time with only one effort? Well, that is possible. And the best way to do it is to have the mathematical models in a meta platform like OPSEC. And then you generate the link to any specific optimization technology. We try to separate the way to do mathematical models from the optimization technology. Because frequently, we take the problem, then we choose a technology, let's say GANs, but then, if someone asks us to use another technology, we have to start the project again. Because this technology has a different syntax, a different implementation, so OPSEC separates the mathematical model from the optimization technology. And this is the connectivity vision we have. At base, you can find the optimization libraries. Then, with OPSEC, you can generate a C program. And a person that doesn't know about C language can generate it automatically and then solve it. With OPSEC, you can call to any computer program to grind your GANs, OPL, C Console, IMPL. But also with OPSEC, you use the cloud to solve your problem. You just have to analyze what kind of problem do you have and then choose the most appropriate server to solve the problem, connect remote access with that server, and solve your problem. Finally, there is another level of technology related with optimization, and this is for bigger systems oriented to the decision support systems. Right now, we are connected to ANS, ODME, and SQL. And OPSEC by itself is a tool at this level. If you only want to work with OPSEC, you can take the C program, then you can do the optimization with Point, for example, that is a free software. So you can optimize your problem without buying alliances. And this is very important nowadays because licenses is very expensive. It will act as a processor. It's oriented to cover all the life cycle of a mathematical model. Since the mathematical model, the algebraic the matrix generation, then use an optimization solver, save everything into a database, and then the analytics is not going to do solvers right now, but it's possible to work with people interested in develop solvers. And usually we have an algebraic language, but the end clients have their own languages. So right now, so analytics is working in a computer algebraic language that will have all the capabilities of objects. Another thing we have learned in objects is the client doesn't need a model. The client needs a set of models, and then he has to link all those models. With objects, we use an information system, knowing all those models and make them compatible in such a way that the system information has tables that are used by the linked models. For example, a demand model will produce some tables, and then maybe the tactical planning model could read those tables, and after that, the production model also will use those tables. In general, we can share all the tables that are in the information system. Objects need three technologies: the information system, the optimization technologies, and control and visualization technologies. We are really focused on the modeler, and this is what the modeler needs to learn. And objects guarantees and deals everything about the information system and help him to visualize the data as the client needs. The main interest of Duo Analytics and our mission is the optimization, and we are committed with the optimization and the final model. Well, now I'm going to show you some very important characteristics of objects. The main difference with objects with all other technologies, optimization technologies, is that we don't use an algebraic language. We store all the components of a model into an information system. The information system has a basic characteristic, and they are independent of any technology. They are just a way to store the data into an information system. Then, here we have all the information in that information system. We have an information system of mathematical models, and we're going to deposit all the mathematical models on those tables, and we're going to work with them. And that gives us too many advantages, because an information system can be accessed concurrently, because I can fill a table, then another person can be filling other table, or two persons can be working on the same table. And they just have to accomplish some normalization rules, some interior rules. So the first phase in objects is to separate the mathematical model from the information, from the optimization technologies, and put everything into an information system. When you use objects, the mathematical modeler just has to think the model, and then objects will make the software for them. And objects will make it in several optimization technologies, for example, C, Muscle, OPL, GANs. And objects guarantees the portability of the mathematical model between optimization technologies. So this is the traditional way of the process of a mathematical model. You identify the problem in the real life, then the decision makers will call the modelers. The modelers will think the model, will write it, and when they have read it, they want to call the programmers, and the programmers will write the code into a specific optimization technology. But now, with objects, our approach radically changed. We identify the real problem, then the decision makers will call the modelers. The modelers will think the model, But now they're just going to fill tables. They're going to call objects, and objects will generate the code for them in any optimization technology they want. Also, they can use or they can decide to solve the problem in the cloud. For example, if we have a tactic planning model that emulates operations and sales, and we need to incorporate all the financial areas, when we do this, maybe the original model is no longer a linear model. It's not a convex model. Then, if I'm working with a technology that does not support linear, non-linear models, I'm not going to be able to do the change. However, if I work with objects, when I realize my model turns to be a non-linear model, I can do the change of technology without losing my model. Recently, we added Optex Excel, and with Optex Excel, the mathematical modelers can formulate multi-model decision support systems with no knowledge about computer technologies. They can generate complex models in several algebraic computer languages linked to any data server that supports ODBC connections. And this is what we have. Here we have two big files, the data model, the algebraic model. Then we're going to fill blanks. We're going to use Excel. We're going to fill a data table. Excel will produce PDF files and will export it to Optex. Optex will generate a code in any optimization technology. When we look at Optex Excel in the cycle, it's something like this. We have the two data, the data model. We will produce the data in Excel. We have the algebraic model, and we fill tables in Excel. We'll use the interface of Optex Excel, and this will produce the CDF files exported to Optex. Optex will use any of these ones that you want to generate the code, and then we'll deliver everything to a graphic user interface to see the results. For the mathematical modelers that prefer computer algebraic languages, the analytic right now is working in a computer algebraic language that will have all the capabilities that Optex offers to the users of the database algebraic language. Optex supports three ways to solve the problem: the low-level languages, high-level languages, or it can go directly to the cloud, connect to a remote server, and solve the problem. Optex generates a structured program for each model, is error-free, and easy to understand the code, because all the descriptions that exist in the database are translated to the program. The multilingual capacity of Optex allowed us to describe, have described in multiple languages, and then it is possible to put the same model in different languages. This is what we already have implemented. The most developed are GANs, C and NILOC, followed by AMIS, FICO, IMPL, and GROVE. Also, I want to mention the remote server scheme. Optex works as a client server. A user of Optex generates a client server environment with a minimal parameterization in an easy way. And this optimizes the use of server licenses and computer resources. Another important characteristic in Optex is the generation of RTF documents. Optex accesses the database and generates a document with all the information in the database in a clear way. And we can see the set, the parameters, the constraints, and this is very useful for the end users. Also, we have the implemented advanced services. They are usually needed to work more comfortable. In this effective example, I can add artificial variables to the constraints that I want. Optex generates automatically the same code and solve it. And I didn't do anything. I just indicate that I will do another kind of analysis that allows to work faster. Prefixa solution is very easy in Optics. We only have to give a value to the variable, but in practice, it implies to add constraints, create new tables, but all this automatically in Optics does it automatically. Also, we have parametric optimization, and we have implemented parallel optimization. In Optics, the organization of a model is a set of problems. A problem is a set of constraints, and solve it implies a communication protocol between them. Also, we have implemented a stochastic optimization. This is very important. It's very normal to have a stochastic model nowadays. And we have done this in Optics. Any model implemented in Optics can automatically be transformed to an optimization problem. The structure of Optics allows the automatic conversion of a deterministic model into a stochastic model. Optics includes the concept of uncertainty dimensions related to any scenario, a set of parameters or topologies that can be correlated. One model may have an unlimited number of uncertain dimensions, and the characters of a stochastic is temporal state. Then it is possible to have multiple models at the same time with different uncertain dimensions. Optics also supports large-scale optimization methodologies like distributed programming, Lagrangian relaxation, and tendency decomposition. Also, with this, you update the model using multiple cores. Optics generates the information system and a graphic user interface to the end users. With this graphic user interface, Optics incorporates any services oriented to help and mathematical models. These services are helpful in the implementation of the information system. You can load the data to the SQL service and check the integrity of that data. And you can do this without knowledge about SQL programming. Also, we have an interactive solver that helps the mathematical modelers to see all the details of the matrix generation process. You can see what's going on step by step with the variables, with the constraints. But when you have a very large model, you need a big data processor because it is almost impossible to do this, to be what's going on with your variables step by step when you have a very large model. And what do we do with the results? Well, generally we connect to Excel to visualize the results. But if the client is using another tool, another visualization tool, you know, for example, Tableau, well, Optics automatically loads the results to Tableau also. We started in 1991 to implement the models. And we have had the opportunity to develop a lot of models. For example, in supply chain, demand chain, transport system, educational system, etc. Right now, Zero Analytics is looking for technological alliances with universities and research centers and for business partners with the aim of expanding its activities. Well, I just want to remind you that the best way to make optimization server